Hello everyone and welcome to New Tech Tuesday Tutorials. My name is Richard Evans. Make sure that you like, comment, and subscribe. Today I want to show you how to use Photoshop files in TriCaster. You'll need premium access or a TriCaster 2 Elite to do this, and it will allow you to bring in PSD files and give you the ability to turn layers on and off as you need them. So that gives you the flexibility to use the same graphic in a buffer bin and simply turn on and off for layers for different looks. Pretty simple and powerful technique to bring your shows to life. So let me show you how it's done, son. Okay, so I'm going to start off on my desktop where I have Adobe Photoshop opened, and I've created a few different layers here for some on-screen graphics that I want to use as like a lower third slash upper bug, etc. So you'll see here that I have, the bottom right, I have a text field here that I've put in place so that we can go through and add text as we see it on the TriCaster side. And then I have a bunch of different layers of graphics here. So for example, I have my upper third bug with this New Tech logo. And I can turn that off, for example. And then you'll also see I have a couple different layers here for this image that's behind the text. So I can turn these off, and I have a couple different looks to choose from here. So just some cool different graphics here. And also I have like a black border here in the background and a white border here. So I have different options to choose from whenever I send this over to the TriCaster. So now what I'm going to do is just save this just as a regular old PSD file. So I'm going to save that, and you can bring it over to the TriCaster via a USB drive, a network attached storage, email it to yourself, however, just make sure you bring it over to the TriCaster. All right, so I moved over here to my TriCaster, and let me bring in that PSD file I just saved. Click on this plus button in my buffers. Now keep in mind that you will need to bring it into one of your buffers. If you throw it into a graphics bin, it is not going to work the same way. All right, so let's go ahead and navigate and find my file here. There it is, my PSD file. Didn't have to do anything fancy from Photoshop, just brought it in as a native PSD file. All right, so I have it loaded into my downstream key number one. Let's go ahead and bring it on screen. All right, so you can see that I have my text layer here, and then I have my graphic, my borders, which aren't quite lined up correctly, but we'll fix that here in a second, and then also that New Tech bug in the top right. So to go through and to edit this, what we'll do is we'll open up the text field for my buffer number 3 and check this out. So first things first, you'll see here I have an option to put in some text. So I'll just go ahead and type my name in there. And again, you have options for changing the font here and making it bold, italicize it, move the size around, etc. Okay. So, all right, we have that going on there, but let's say that we want to go through and start to change the different elements of this. What you'll need to go is to the top right of this buffer number 3 configuration, and you'll see that we have options to see all of those same layers that I made in Photoshop, but here on the TriCaster. So for example, I can turn on and off that upper third bug. So boop, that New Tech logo's gone. Let's go ahead and bring it back. I can also go ahead and let's get rid of that white border because it's kind of showing from underneath the other one because I didn't make my file very well apparently. Get rid of that. Or I can swap it to make it have the black border, and now I have the white border instead. But the black border looks better. All right, bad design, Richard. All right, so put that back on, and let's say, okay, so that the text here kind of interferes with these blue bubbles we have in the background. So let's go ahead and choose something else. I can bring in that one, that shattered glass looking logo, or bring on the space looking logo. That one looks pretty cool, and we'll leave that the way that is. So this gives you a bunch of different options to go through, and say you're in the middle of a broadcast, or in the middle of a show, and you want to have a whole bunch of different graphics and kind of change up your look a little bit. This would be a great way to do it. And there's, I can see tons of different applications to be able to do this, just to be able to bring on different things and bring it all into one buffer instead of having to fill up a whole bunch of different buffers or graphics bins to accomplish this exact same task. So some really cool things you can do with this. And as usual, I highly recommend going and playing around with it. And have some fun. So, as you can see, using Photoshop files in your TriCaster production with premium access is a great way to customize your show. You can find out more about premium access, TriCaster, and more by contacting your local reseller or visiting our website, newtech.com. For more tutorial videos like this one, hit the subscribe button on the New Tech YouTube channel, youtube.com/newtechinc. And for formal New Tech product training, check out New Tech University at newtech.com/newtech-u. And lastly, if you are posting your work on social media, tag us using the hashtags NewTech or TriCaster. You'll see me in your likes. Thank you again for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments, and I'll see you next time for another edition of NewTech Tuesday Tutorials. Yup.